Hello everyone. So as you can see from the paper that we have to show that by graphically we have to show that x minus 2y is equal to 2 and 4x minus 2y is equal to 5 are consistent. Now if we take two straight line a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. If we take these two straight line, now for consistency it is necessary that a1 by a2 should be not equal to b1 by b2. Now here if we take these two straight line, we are getting a1 is equal to 1, a2 is equal to 4, b1 is equal to minus 2, b2 is equal to minus 2. So a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 4, b1 by b2 is equal to 1. So obviously here a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, so it is consistent. Now we have to show it in by graphical method. Since I have no proper graph paper, just I am showing a rough solution of this so that you will be understood. Actually I have already made this this video, but again I am, since the video is not fully completed, again I am doing this. Now here x minus 2y is equal to 2. From here we are getting x by y, there is 0 minus 1, 2 corresponding value, minus 2, minus 2. And as you can see from here, we are getting that y for 2y is equal to 4x minus 5. So y is equal to 4x minus 5 by 2. From here, x by y is equal to 0 by minus 2.5, 1 by 0.5 and minus 1 by 4.5. Okay. Now we have to put this value in the graph paper, and we see that these two straight line must intersect at one point. If two straight line intersect in one point, then we can say that that two straight line are consistent. Okay, this is the graphical representation of consistency of two straight line. Okay. Now here, as you can see, if we plot, we have already plotted the straight line from here, and we are getting, this is the straight line of 4x minus 2y is equal to 5, and this is x minus 2y is equal to 2. Okay, we have already plotted the points also for first straight line. This is 0 comma minus 1, next 2 comma 0, next minus 2 comma 2. As you can see, you have to plot this in graph paper. Mind it, this is a rough solution, not proper solution. You have to solve it in graph paper. Now this is minus 1 comma minus 4.5 for this straight line. This is 1 comma 0.5, okay, and this is 0 comma minus 2.5, 0 comma minus 2.5, this straight line. Now if we draw these two straight lines, we can see that these two straight lines are intersecting at one point, this point. Okay, this point, if we name it as P, so we can see that these points are intersecting at one point, and that is the condition for consistency. Understood. Now if we have to solve this point P, then you have to solve this two straight line equation by any of the method, that is either elimination method or substitution method. Elimination method, if you apply, you will get this solution point, the coordinate of this point. Okay, next move to another question. Next we are taking another question. So by graphically these two straight line are inconsistent. Now here if we comp for inconsistency, a1 by a2, that should be equals to b1 by b2. Okay, and that not should be equals to c1 by c2. So this is the condition of for inconsistency. Now here a1 is equal to 2, b1 is equal to 3, and c1 is equal to minus 4, okay, and a2 is equal to 4, b2 is equal to 6, and c2 is equal to minus 12, if we considering it these two terms as c1, c2, understood, constant term. So here we can see that 2 by 4, that's equals to 3 by 6, that's not equal to minus 4 by minus 12, that is, this is equal to 1 by 2, that's equal to 1 by 2, that's not equal to 1 by 3, okay. So these are inconsistent. Now we have to show that by graphically. For that we have to take this straight line, that is 2x plus 3y equal to 4. Now 3y is equal to 4 minus 2x. Now y is equal to 4 minus 2x by 3. X by y. If we take x is equal to 2, we are getting y is equal to 0. If we take x is equal to minus 3, we take x equal to minus 4, we are getting x equal to 4. And if we take x is equal to, suppose we are taking x is equal to minus 1, then the value we are getting 2, okay. Next, another, that is 4x plus 6y is equal to 12. From here again, if we divide it, we are getting 2x plus 3y, that's equals to 6. From here 3y is equal to 6 minus 2x, and y is equal to 6 minus 2x by 3. So x by y is equal to, now if we take x is equal to 0, we are getting y is equal to 2. If we take x is equal to x equal to 3, the value of y should be 0. If we take x is equal to minus 3, this value should be, value of y should be 4. So now we should plot this point in graph page. This is the graph page. Suppose we are taking, this is the rough sketch, I am again telling you, this is the graph 0. Now we have to draw the first straight line, that is x is 2,0. So 1, 2, this point is 2,0. Next minus 4,4, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 4,4, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is minus 4,4, okay. Next minus 1,2, this is minus 1,2, 1, 2, minus 1,2. So this is one point, this is one point, this is another point. So this we have to join first. Now we are joining this. And we are, so this represent 2x plus 3y equal to 4, straight line. Next another straight line, that is, hope you are able to see, 0, 2, that means 0, 2, this point, 0 2, next 3 0, 3 0, this point, and next another point -3, 4, that is this is -3, 4, 1 2 3 3 4, this point. So this point is -3, 4. So now if we join this point, we will get a straight line which is exactly parallel to the given straight line. As you can see, if we draw this by graph page, that will be very perfect, but for my picture that will be also. So this is the equation of 4x + 6y = 12. Okay, since these two straight lines are getting parallel, so there will be no common point, no common intersecting point. Okay, so and they will never intersect. So the system of linear equation that is given, that is inconsistent, and this is the graphical representation required, okay. This is x, this is x dash, this is y, this is y dash, okay, and this is the origin. Hope you are able to understood it. Next, move to another question. Next, one question I am taking, that a polynomial is given, polynomial px equals to 2x² + 5x - 12, and these are the zeros given. Of these two polynomials, okay, there is -4 and 3/2. These are the zeros of this polynomial 2x² + 5x - 12 is given. We have to verify the relation between the zeros and coefficient. Okay, now since it is a quadratic polynomial, so for a quadratic polynomial, so comparing this polynomial to ax² + bx + c, we are comparing this polynomial to this and taking the zeros as alpha beta, where alpha is equal to -4, beta is equal to 3/2, then alpha plus beta should be -b/a, and alpha beta should be c/a. Now here my alpha plus beta is equal to -4 + 3/2, that's equals to 2, means -5/3, and here -b/a, that means -5/2 here, and here this is -b/a, that means -5, this is -5/a. So it is verified, the sum is verified. Now alpha beta means what? -4 × 3/2, that means -6, okay, that's equals to, that should be equal to c/a, that is -12/2, that's equals to -6. So -6 is equal to -6, so that is also verified. Okay, so these are the some solution. Next I am taking another question, that is so that 12x plus 18y is equal to 21 and 4x plus 6y is equal to 7 have infinitely many solution. Infinitely many solution. Okay. Now here, for infinitely many solution, what we have to check, that is a1 by a2, that should be equals to b1 by b2, that should be equals to c1 by c2. Now here a1 equal to 4, this equation should be come first, and a2 is equal to 12, b1 equal to 6, b2 is equal to 18, c1 is equal to 7, c2 is equal to 21. Okay, minus 7 minus 21, if we take the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0, if we take this form. Okay, so here if we check it, we are getting that 4 by 12, that's equals to 6 by 18, obviously that's equals to minus 7 by minus 21. That means 1 by 3 equals to 1 by 3 equals to 1 by 3. So we can say that these two straight line has infinitely IMS, infinitely many solution. Hope you are able to understand it. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe the channel for getting math related videos.